Hi there, I'm Christine, and this is the Freedom Update, the bi-weekly video podcast from the Canadian Constitution Foundation, where we give you updates about our ongoing cases, tell you about interesting constitutional developments from across Canada, and give you information about how to join us for upcoming events. Thanks for tuning in, and let's talk about freedom. In my last Freedom Update, I told you about a new case that we weren't quite ready to announce yet. The case would be challenging Ontario's lockdown and stay-at-home order. Well, that case is now live and I'm excited to tell you about it today. There's a challenge that's been brought by North X Fit, a gym in Waterloo that's independently owned and has a special focus on serving the disability community. Let me tell you a little bit about the case, the gym, and the people who go there. So North X Fit is a gym in Kitchener-Waterloo. It was founded by a mom, an athlete, and disability advocate who wanted to make physical fitness more accessible to the entire community, including those with special needs. The founder of the gym wanted to build a unique place where everyone would feel welcome and included. The gym has invested in special adaptive equipment that can be used safely by individuals with physical disabilities. The personal trainers at the gym have special qualifications that help them train individuals living with physical and mental disabilities. Many of the gym's clients use physical fitness as a way of managing their disabilities, whether it's a brain injury or a mobility challenge or a developmental challenge. Now, the province-wide lockdown that came into effect on December 26 has meant that North X Fit has had to close. Now, the owner and the clients didn't want the gym to close, but that's the law. Many of the clients of North X Fit are unable to work out at home because of their disabilities. They either lack the expensive adaptive equipment or they need assistance or supervision to work out. Telling a visually impaired person to watch a YouTube video at home as a way of staying fit is ignorant and insensitive. Yet that's what the government seems to be expecting North X Fit's clients to be doing. But even for the few clients who do want to stay connected virtually, the stay-at-home order means that the trainers can't even drive to the gym to run an online class. Physical fitness is important for everyone's well-being, including individuals with special needs. And it's incredibly important to stay healthy and active during a pandemic, but the lockdown is making it incredibly hard for many people to stay fit and healthy because gyms have been ordered closed. And for individuals with special needs, it's virtually impossible. And of course, the lockdown isn't affecting everyone equally. Gyms are shut for ordinary citizens, including citizens with special needs, but they remain open for elite classes. High-performance athletes like the Toronto Maple Leafs are permitted to train in their exclusive and elite gyms. Millionaire 20-year-olds are given special privileges, while individuals with special needs are denied the right to maintain their health through fitness programs like the ones offered at this gym bringing this challenge. You know, I was devastated when I read some of these stories, and we know that there are so many more from gyms and businesses across Canada. And that's why we're joining the fight, and I'm excited to announce that just this past Wednesday, the Canadian Constitution Foundation was granted intervener status to participate in this court fight. We'll be making arguments in support of the gym's legal position in court in the coming weeks. If you want to follow along, we can keep you updated through this video update and through our mailing list, which you can subscribe to at www.theccf.ca. There are some interesting constitutional developments from across Canada, and this week we're going to be checking in with the federal government. The federal government has announced a new set of restrictions on travelers returning to Canada. Prime Minister Trudeau announced in a press conference on January 29th that not only are travelers required to get a COVID test to board a plane to Canada, they now must get a second test when they land. And while they wait for the results of that test, they're required to quarantine for up to 3 days in a government quarantine hotel. The cost for the test and the quarantine stay is estimated to be over $2,000 per traveler. Since this announcement was made, I've heard from hundreds of Canadians that this is going to impact. I've heard from Canadians who have traveled for specialized medical care or for their child's medical care. Are these people going to be accommodated in the quarantine hotel? Will the quarantine hotels meet specialized medical needs? I've also talked to people who have to travel for work or have to travel because they're in a cross-border marriage? How would you feel if your husband and children were on one side of the border and you were on the other, and there's now a new $2,000 price tag attached to seeing them? I know I would feel pretty terrible. I've talked to people who have had to travel for other compassionate reasons, for example, funerals for parents or siblings, or to assist loved ones who are sick or dying. And I've talked to people who are traveling with guide dogs or people traveling with young children. How will the quarantine hotels accommodate large families or animals? Will families be separated? Are the rooms big enough? You know, the government announced a blanket policy imposing a broad quarantine requirement, but now nearly a week later, we don't have any of the details being provided. No wonder people are panicking. The quarantine policy has the potential to implicate our fundamental charter protected rights, and it's reckless for the government to announce a policy without having the details sorted out. I've written to the federal government asking for accommodation for people traveling for medical reasons. These people must be exempted from this quarantine hotel requirement and permitted to quarantine in the safety of their homes. But the reality is that most people can be trusted to quarantine at home anyway. The government hasn't provided evidence that travelers are violating the 14-day home quarantine requirement. And in the absence of such evidence, imposing a quarantine in a government facility is really excessive. We're waiting to see what the final order in council looks like, which should outline what the exemptions are. When it's published, I'll be sure to keep you updated. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel and watch our video updates, or you can join our mailing list at www.theccf.ca. I have some exciting events to tell you about, and I hope you'll be able to join us. The first is a webinar that our friends at the Runnymede Society are organizing called The Rule of Law and the Role of Lawyers in Times of Conflict. The speaker is David French, senior editor of The Dispatch and noted constitutional litigator. I'll share the link in the video description. I hope you register and join us for this free event. I also have exciting news to share about my TV program that I have been guest hosting, Canadian Justice. The program is on the channel The News Forum, which is carried on Bell. And I'm going to be transitioning into hosting this program full time. Upcoming episodes include topics like these travel restrictions that I've just talked about, Ontario's stay-at-home order, and youth sentencing. Episodes air on weeknights at 8 p.m. Please tune in and watch. That's all for this update. Thanks for watching, and let's keep fighting for freedom in Canada.